probably a lot of you are here today to learn about explainable AI and how it can help us make AI trustworthy and applicable in healthcare. But I'm here to tell you that explainable AI is a dangerous illusion. But I will also provide an alternative way forward. We will derive something I call the uncertainty principle of meaning. It involves precision, which is how well we or AI models understand something. And it correlates with the performance or power of these models. But we also have complexity, which is the complexity we need to explain or describe something that we know. And this is the opposite of explainable. And we're going to see the ratio between precision and complexity is constant, meaning that it is always a trade-off. And more power and precision always comes at the cost of explainability. In short, the more you know, the more you realize you don't know. Of course, this applies anywhere where we apply AI, but it's extra important when it comes to AI in healthcare, because now it's so obvious that we're now submitting our lives to the unknown of AI. So we really have to face these challenges head on. In deriving this, we're going to ask, for this new era of AI, how do they actually understand what meaning is? And we're going to see that actually corresponds to how we human beings learn and understand meaning. And we define meaning by the company it keeps. You don't learn what a dog is from your parents telling you or from your emotions guiding you. You learn what a dog is by observing dogs in different contexts, by contrasting and correlating dog with other concepts. A dog is something that's walked by an owner with a leash. It's something that has an antagonistic relationship with cats. It's something that chases frisbees when those are thrown. This is what allows you to understand what a dog is. And what you get from this is a very relational understanding of meaning. As you correlate and contrast dogs with other concepts, like cats, you in turn learn what cats are. And it works across modalities. Language, dog as a word will be uttered more in context where dogs appear. So the more relations that you're able to understand, the better understanding you get of each individual concept. There's a synergies and network effects at play. You understanding love helps you understand what a dog is, because an owner loves his dog. So why not train a huge model and on as much data as possible to learn as many relations as possible to get the most precise and powerful understanding, and then apply that model anywhere where any of these concepts appear? Well, that's a foundation model, like the GPT models. But also your brain is a prime example. So really, the best definition of meaning is actually relations. In our brain, it's the neurons. In our AI models, it's the parameters. But this means that precision or power, right, is directly related to number of relations involved. But so is complexity, because more parameters and more neurons are hard to compress and hard to explain. And that's why the ratio between change in precision over change in complexity has to remain constant. There's a fundamental trade-off. This is why we now see our great AI models having a performance and precision that goes to infinity, but that also necessitates that the complexity goes to infinity. When we have the human brain, ChatGPT and Dall-E, they also must come with 1 trillion parameters. The uncertainty principle was coined by Heisenberg to explain the fundamental imprecision in the physical world. Einstein complained and said, well, no, everything should be explainable and precise because God doesn't play dice. Well, if God did create human intelligence, he did play dice because he did machine learning. Right, we have to give up explainability, so what do we do? Well, if God is a machine learning engineer, what was his test and validation sets? Right, the two main tools that we use in AI to build trust and test our models. I'd say it's a test of time. In fact, the biggest difference between human intelligence and artificial intelligence is the time over which it was developed. Human intelligence has been developed over roughly the last 3.5 billion years, while the new era of AI has been developed over the last 3.5 years. So that's off by a factor of a billion. And the great challenge will be, how do we apply robust tests of time when it comes to this new era of AI? Because we don't trust what we can explain, we trust what's earned our trust by the test of time. Most people feel more safe in cars than they do in airplanes, even though statistics explain to us that airplanes are more safe. But that's not true for each individual person, because most people spend more time in cars, arriving safely at the destinations, than they do in airplanes. And that's why they trust cars more, not because they can explain the car or the opposing driver. And this does apply and will apply when it comes to AI and healthcare. We don't trust doctors because we can explain them. We trust them because they're familiar to us and they've earned our trust. We have to give the chance to AI to earn our trust as well, to submit them to real tests of time. So we will solve the technology we already almost have, right? And we're already building training sets by measuring and collecting data. And if you want the power and precision and performance, explainability is not a viable path forward, and it's not actually what we care about. So the real challenge here is to get the test and validation sets to be able to simulate the test of time. And it's scary to think about, but with the speed that we're moving with right now, right, as an order of magnitude, 1 year right now corresponds to roughly 1 billion years of evolution. And we also have to give up understanding and be able to explain what we're building, which shows us the shaky grounds that we're on. This new era of AI can be our greatest accomplishment or our downfall. So I guess this will be our greatest test of time. Thank you.